Join us online at charlierose.com.
I mean, I think the directorial achievement of The Good German is just astonishing, really. The ambitions of the film, I think, are really astonishing.
The ambitions in what way?
I just think to make a hybrid form, really, to use actors with very sort of a politically savvy actors, like George, to place them in a political context, which is the beginning of the Cold War, and a story told largely from the vanquished perspective of the Second World War, which history never tells, you know, it's always told from the victor's point of view. And I thought, well, that's fascinating, and I expected to be shooting in Romania,
yes,
in colour. Right. And then I found out that we were shooting on the Universal backlot in black and white, using the old cameras.
And how does it change for you if they're using the old cameras?
Well, that wasn't such a change for me, because they made different noises. It was the primary change was in the acting style, that I think when we're so used to receiving war stories with blood and guts realism, and it's almost like we've become desensitized to the politics of that, because we receive so many violent images. And the fact that all of this stuff was suddenly stylized, shot in black and white, I think you attend much more, not only to the visuals, but to the words when you're watching a black and white film.
Join us online at charlierose.com.